Mace production. I can't hear y'all clapping. Spirit in here now. Somebody better get a shout on, because you don't know what tomorrow is going to hold. Oh! Somebody pray. Glory.
I count not myself to have apprehended.
I don't count myself as the one that made it conquer.
But this one thing I do.
But this is one thing I can say that I do.
Forgetting those things which are behind.
I am able to forget those things that are behind me, things that happened before today.
And reaching forth unto those things which are before.
And I'm trying to grab the things that is ahead of me. Mm-hmm.
I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus.
I can't get nothing looking back, but I got to press forward to try to get those things that are before me. I have to press for the prize of the higher calling of God in Jesus Christ. Thank you. Let's say amen. Amen. I'm going to talk today from the old passage of Scripture for a few moments from a subject, the formula for a successful life. The formula for a successful life. When I think of formula, I think of a scientist in the laboratory mixing stuff together, perhaps, and putting in a bottle, something similar to this. Putting all the ingredients, kind of come up with whatever he's seeking to find with certain power, like the atomic bomb. Trying to find a cure for a certain disease. He find a formula that he could put together to guarantee release or an effect of what he's trying to get. So today I'm talking about a formula for a successful life. I want to ask a question, first of all. How many of you feel like
do you need this formula
you
today?
Have been successful for a successful life. And before I begin to talk about our text today, I want to explain the word formula. The formula is something that you do according to a fixed custom. It is something that has been tested to bring to pass that which it said it could accomplish. For example, it could be a tradition of something. It's the custom that they do because it brings about the results every time. Amen. It's a formula that has been put together, something that can fix things or to shape things. You know something about dressing formula. They say, we're going to a get-together. They say, is it going to be semi or is it going to be formula or what? When we say formula, that means it's an outward show. It's something that tries to give the impression of what is taking place. Like, for instance, a wedding. It wouldn't hardly come to a wedding. Well, I don't know what they do. They're doing everything nowadays. With a pair of blue jeans, according to the Bible. Success is not in a man accumulation and achieving great wealth. Success is not one going to school or in college and graduating with honor, with certain degree, as we would think. Our text today will defile all of those things. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
I'm talking today about a formula for a successful life. All of us would like, in our right mind, to have a successful life or to be successful at something. When one's life is not meeting that expectation of being successful, we feel like we are failures. Some of you feel like you have failed because you haven't landed a husband yet. Some of you who landed one lost it. Our wife lost it. Every woman feel like they're successful. Most of them feel like they've been cheated if they don't have a man.
Ain't that strange how people
y'all want to act a little different in the church, and especially when they're around the preacher or something. They want to act all holy, all sedated, like they care less about a man. And every time you look around, they arguing and bickering and in trouble with one or having their belly full of. And you hear them singing that night, "I'm so lonely. They don't want to be, I'm so tired of being alone." But yet they want to act like that's not an interesting thing. That's just nothing but being deceived. Man was not made to live alone. So success is not based upon one wealth or one relationship with another. But when we talk about success, I looked it up in the dictionary. But for all of this that he says, he called it as dung. All his wealth, all the prestige that he had, all the people loving him and caring about him, amen, his wits, his intelligence, his achievements, all of this was credit to his ability to do things. He was one, it is said, that could speak 7 languages influently without having to go to school for it. He could speak and preach to folk in Greek as well as he could his own countrymen, the Jews. I can't hardly speak English as I stand to talk to you today. But the Apostle Paul had all this to his credibility. He had went to the best schools of his day. One who was the greatest teacher during his time was a man called Gamaliel. Paul had sat under his... I'm going to tell you the truth, whether you like it or not. The Bible said in the law, the Pharisees knew that if you violate in one part of the law, you're guilty of the whole law. I told you on one Wednesday night, if you don't fornicate and say you have never done that or don't commit adultery, if you violate any of the law, you're still an adultery. You might not physically laid up with one, but you sure dreamed about him. I think I'm on the truth right here. The law. Nobody know what's in your mind. You ain't got nothing to boast about because you done do that and do that, but you're doing all the other stuff. You're just as guilty. So Paul had all this to his credential, his credibility. Yeah. So here he is in our text today. Let me talk just a few more minutes. Ease on back down in your seat and hold what you got. Yes. He said, "I know I persecuted the church. In the law, I was blameless." But note the 7th verse. He said, "But what thing was gained to me? Thank you, Jesus. Those I count loss for Christ. All of my intellect, all of my schooling, all of my stock being a Jew, all of me being connected to Israel, all of that I counted loss. I didn't gain a thing for what all I done." Say yes. That's why I got a formula for a successful life. Yes. And the first formula, the thing on the formula, is the first thing. Paul said, "I have not apprehended. I have not conquered what I need to conquer. I have not became what I should be." Say yes. "I have not taken hope to it. I have not lived the way I should live." Say yes. "I have not done what I should have done." But here's the formula. But this is one thing. Somebody say one thing that I do. I'm forgetting. Help me say it, say forgetting those things that are behind me. Say yes. That's what's wrong with a lot of y'all. You always looking back. You always thinking backwards. You always looking at what you have and not what you can gain. You always looking where you come from, but not where you're going. Say yeah. So the first formula is this. In order to be successful and a good life and a good living, the first thing you got to do is forget. Everybody say forget. Those things that are behind is a new day. Every day is a new beginning. Say yeah. If you were troubled about what happened last night, start off again on the day. It's a new day. If you want to be successful and how to live happy, forget about the past. Forget about who did this. Forget about who said that. Forget about where you've been. Forget about who you are. And think about who God is. Say yeah. Say yeah. I'm trying to tell somebody. You can't live forward. You can't be happy today. Always looking back at yesterday. What you said and what you done. If you want a day, is a new day. It's time for me to start again. I got a new chance. I got another opportunity. I'm going to make the best out of today. I'm making the best out of my life right now. You don't have to like me. You don't have to know my name. You don't have to agree with me. I don't care what I've been through. I don't care what I'm going through. I know that God gave me another chance. I got a new start. I'm somebody. I'm forgetting about all the sermons I preached during the year. All the money I put in the church, I'm forgetting all about it. I'm going to start giving on the day. I'm going to do better today. I'm going to forget about what you said about me. I'm forgetting about the lie you told on me. Say yeah. But that's the first formula. Forgetting those things that are behind. And the next part of the formula, got to mix it with part one, part two. Say yeah. I press towards the mark of the prize of the high calling that in Jesus. If you want to be successful, you got to become especially. I said especially. You got to have one thing in your mind and one thing only. Do I have any witness? One thing that I need. One thing that I desire. And that is to inquire in his temple the goodness of the Lord. Oh! Help me say, all that I need is to press forward to try to get Jesus. My mind is on pleasing him. I'm not worried so much about pleasing the wife. I'm not worried about pleasing you. I want to please God. I specialize in pleasing God. Do I have anybody that want to please God? And that's number one on your list. I got to do what God said. You might not like me, but I press to please the Lord. I'm striving to do what God said. I'm going forward and not backwards. I'm not going to let you pull me back. I'm not going to let you drag me down. Say yeah, I'm going forward because the mark, the price is ahead of me. I got to go straight, make straight path for my feet. I'm pressing, it gets hard. Sometime I have to cry all by myself, all night long, all alone, but I'm pressing towards the mark for the prize of the high calling. I said high calling because Jesus have called me. He's calling me from the earth to heaven. I got to forget what the earth is doing. I got to forget what this word is bringing up on me. My mind is set. My eyes is on the crown. Say yes. Say yes. Yeah. I'm pressing all the hard, but I'm pushing and I'm pulling. I'm trying to go forward. You might be tugging on me, but that's all right. I got to press. Help me say press. I got to go through whatever come on me. I got to keep going no matter how I feel. I got to keep going no matter what's happening. I got to keep going no matter what it look like, no matter what it feel like. I got to go forward, 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 broke but forward, down but forward, sick but forward, hurting but forward, misunderstood but forward, lied on but forward, say ow!
About your heritage, please stop by the Cosby Educational Heritage Center in the Ocey Hill Neighborhood Center at 445 Bowman Street. For appointments, please call us at 419-775-8834 or 419-571-4627. And always remember, education is the key.
The gift of you were born with a grace.
The gift that looks good on you.
That grace is your gift.
The gift that looks good on you.
It's a divine enablement.
The gift that looks good on you.
If you work your grace, the grace will work for you. Company, teach the lesson.
The systems of the world try to take your confidence.
Yes, they will.
For these systems were designed.
Designed.
To make you doubt what heaven said.
Don't you doubt.
The systems of the world.
These systems
try to take your confidence.
Yes, they will.
For these systems were designed.
Designed.
To make you sit down on
Don't you let
me. But the gift God gave to you,
this gift,
give it back to him.
Offer it up.
When he sees